Good evening, and welcome to the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society Spring Video Concert, Music for the Heavens and the Heart. Tonight, we will present several heavenly settings of the Latin texts, Gloria in Excelsis and Laudemus Te. We will also present some modern spirituals, as well as compositions from Craig Courtney, Leonard Bernstein, and our very own W.G. Pete Stokes. Our special guests this evening are Dennis Murphy as our violin soloist and choir members from North Point High School in Waldorf, Maryland, under the leadership of Kristen Helming. You will also hear recordings from past vocal and instrumental soloists from previous concerts. We hope you enjoy Chesapeake Choral Arts Society's Music for the Heavens and the Heart.
Our opening selection is the first movement of Antonio Vivaldi's Gloria. Vivaldi had written at least three settings of this hymn, but only two survive. This setting was possibly written in 1715 and is a more familiar and popular piece among the sacred works of Vivaldi. Translated, this first movement says, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill to all men." Please enjoy the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society with orchestra, this first movement of Vivaldi's Gloria.
Thank you for viewing our spring virtual concert, Music for the Heavens and the Heart. I am Leroy Presley, the current musical director and conductor of the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society. Tonight's musical selections were chosen with the thoughts of texts that are of a promising and uplifting nature. We will be sharing music from our classical concerts and our folk presentations. We have invited as our guest choir the North Point Screechin' Eagles, under the direction of Kristen Helmick, to join us on this program. Since this is our 25th anniversary, we have also asked our founding director, Lynn Schramm, and our director emeritus, Michael Santana, to speak about their time with the group. We are so fortunate to have some of the founding members still performing with us. We have invited them to share a memory of their time with the choir. We will begin our choir with Gloria in Excelsis Deo, Glory to God in Highest, and end it with Take Care of This House. From the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society, please enjoy Music for the Heavens and the Heart.
Another setting of the Latin text, Gloria in Excelsis Deo, is by the famous classical, with a capital C, composer, Joseph Haydn. As an itinerant composer, Haydn composed the Gloria in Excelsis Deo while serving as Kapellmeister for Prince Esterházy at Eisenstadt in Austria. This selection is from the first section of the Gloria, from the Missa Sancti Bernardi Diofida, Heilige Messe, of 1796, one of the Hermenegild Masses composed to celebrate the name day of Princess Marie Hermenegild. With our accompanist, Josh Cockerham on harpsichord, please enjoy Joseph Haydn's setting of Gloria.
A memory from one of our founding and current members, Helen Harrington. 25 years ago, the Maryland Independent ran an announcement for auditions for a brand new choral group in Charles County. Along with some 40 other people selected, I showed up for the first rehearsal at Piney Church in early September and started rehearsing for a Christmas concert. Men, women, ranging from early 20s to senior citizens, we worked to blend our voices and learn the challenging music of Handel's Messiah and Robert Shaw's Many Moods of Christmas. Singing with a full choir, an orchestra, and professional soloists was exciting, something not available to the community before.
We return to another movement from Vivaldi's Gloria. The third movement was written as a duet for sopranos. The text, Laudemus Te, in English means, we praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. Much lighter in texture, Vivaldi uses a little light echo effect, possibly to to stress the importance of the phrases. Enjoy our guest soloists, Amy States and Hannah Basley, as they perform from Vivaldi's Gloria, Laudemus Dei.
Chesapeake Choral Arts Society is privileged to have W.G. Pete Stokes as our in-house composer. He has composed and arranged many selections, not only for our full choir, but also for our small women's group, the Magic Owls, for our men's ensemble, and for many soloists. Here is W.G. Pete Stokes, who is the best person to talk about our next selection.
In the fall of 2017, our singers asked me to engrave a clearer score of Deo Gratias, William Byrd's lovely Renaissance choral piece. Over the years, our copies had become dog-eared and almost illegible. Well, I knew that all the great composers, such as Mozart, had copied other master scores note for note as music students. And so, although I had sung Deo Gratias many times before, after engraving a fresh score, I was delighted that I learned much more about Byrd's wondrous harmonic suspensions and melodic flow. The undertaking really inspired me to compose a short 8-bar choral work of the text, Gloria in Excelsis Deo. However, as it often happens, the muse captured me, compelling me to think of other settings that could connect with the short work. That evolved into the Gloria Variations, resulting in a piece with 6 settings and varied repeats of 4. It was an astonishing coincidence that, unbeknownst to me, I was composing a piece that fit perfectly into Maestro Presley's plans for a future concert featuring works that were all settings of the text Gloria in Excelsis Deo. I was honored and thrilled to have the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society premiere this work in our 2019 A Glorious Concert. My deepest thanks to Maestro Presley, Josh Cockeram, soloists Michael Santana and Denise Pratt, and the entire chorus for their hard work in rehearsing, performing, and beautifully bringing this composition to life.
Thank you.
Francis Poulenc claimed that the idea for his Gloria began while he worked on his opera, Dialogue des Carmelites, Dialogue of the Carmelites. This commissioned work was performed in 1961, 60 years ago, by the Boston Symphony Orchestra in honor of Sergei Koussevitzky, who had been their music director from 1924 to 1949. Chesapeake Choral Arts Society will be performing the second movement, Laudamus Te, which Poulenc said had been inspired by watching the Benedictine monks playing soccer. With the Chamber Orchestra of Southern Maryland in concert, conducted by Vladimir Land, please enjoy from Francis Poulenc's Gloria, Laudamus Te.
Had a song that I'll make reference to that had to do with chickens. So when the time came, as the concert was going on, we all stood there like idiots and went like chickens as much as we could.
Somewhere in the late 90s, we were preparing for our annual spring concert at Grace Lutheran Church. The basses and tenors were searching for a clever way to honor our fearless leader, as we proudly referred to our director, Lynn Schramm. After a chunk of thought, our plan was set in motion. The concert was underway, and during the second half, we finally launched into that lively, upbeat selection perfect to implement our strategy. At the exact moment of the song's climax, each of the men whipped out from their music folders a carefully folded sign, flag shaped about 2.5 feet by 3.5 feet in size, which had the bold inscription, "Go, Lynn, go." The audience just loved it. Thusly stated, a well-deserved little tribute was made to our beloved director.
We tried to have a good time with Lynn, Sometimes she liked what we did, sometimes she didn't, but that was up to her.
This next selection was composed in 2002 by Indiana native Craig Courtney. This piece was originally chosen to be performed by Chesapeake Choral Arts Society's founding director, Lynn Schramm. She led the choir in their performance of this song during the beginning years of this group. Tonight, we present a new, for us, virtual performance style for you, with a violin solo by Dennis Murphy, an organ accompaniment by Kelsey Clark. Please enjoy Peace I Give to You.
During Chesapeake Choral Arts Society's tenure, we've had many members and performances. We would like to remember the members that are no longer with us. We know that they are making beautiful music wherever they are. Let us take a moment to celebrate their life and their time with Chesapeake Choral Arts Society. Thank you.
While we enjoy performing whenever and wherever we can, we also love to share the spotlight with other talented members of our community. Tonight, our special guests are the choral group from North Point High School in Waldorf, Maryland, under the direction of Miss Kristen Helming.
Hello, my name is Aaliyah Winford, and I'm a part of North Point High School's award-winning Screeching Eagles. We would like to thank the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society for inviting us to perform at your concert. Over the course of the pandemic, we have also been meeting virtually, and despite the difficulties that we faced, we produced a song together, originally performed by For King and Country and arranged by Catherine Baudere. Our a cappella choir is a mixed choir comprised of talented individuals from 9th to 12th grade, and we hope you enjoy our performance. Follow us on Instagram for more updates on future performances. Bye!
This is for the busted heart. This is for the question marks. This is for the outcast soul, lost control, no one knows. Sing it for the can't go back. Sing it for the broken past. Sing it for the just found out, life is now upside down. If you're looking for hope tonight, raise your hand. If you're feeling alone and don't understand, if you're fighting in the fight of your life, then stand. We're gonna make it through this hand in hand. And if we fall, we will fall together. Together.
This is for the second chance. This is for the new romance. Sing it for the loved in vain. Overcame. It's not too late.
If you're looking for hope tonight, raise your hand. Yeah. If you're feeling alone and don't understand. If you're fighting to fight your life instead. Yeah. We're gonna make it through this hand in hand. If we fall, we will fall together. Together.
I feel you, my brother. I see you, my sister. Can you feel it?
Woo!
If we fall, we will fall together. Together.
Together we are bolder, braver, stronger.
Hi, I am Mike Gann, a tenor with the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society. We are dedicated to the performance and promotion of choral music in the Southern Maryland communities. We have provided wonderful choral music in Southern Maryland for 25 years. We are the only community choral group in Charles County. We provide opportunities to soloists and orchestra members to ensure our audiences get the full impact of beautiful music. You can get involved right now by clicking the donate button. You can also become involved by providing your name and contact information so that you can become a member of the society. I know that you love choral music. We provide it. We hope you take the time to give a donation to the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society. This community choir enjoys performing, helping in the community, and doing outreach. Your financial contribution helps make our community efforts possible, and thank you.
As the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society began to grow in performances and membership, Lynn Schramm left the choir in the capable hands and musical leadership of Michael Santana. He expanded the choir's repertoire and seasonal offerings. Because of his many years of musical leadership with the choir, the board of directors named him Director Emeritus. We present to you Michael Santana.
Well, I started with the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society in 2003 and stayed for 15 years to 2018. And I think one of the things that I'm most proud of is their ability to grow. And I don't mean grow necessarily in numbers as much as I do in musicianship and musicality. We went from my first season doing the Vivaldi Gloria, which is a standard choral work that most advanced high schools can do as well, to doing something as challenging as the Brahms Requiem in 2017. We also did the Mozart Requiem, the Rudder Requiem, the Andrew Lloyd Webber Requiem. We've certainly done enough Requiems. A wonderful piece called the Chichester Psalms by Leonard Bernstein. And one of the first really challenging pieces that I gave the course was the Symphony of Psalms by Stravinsky. And we literally had people showing up who were in the audience just because they couldn't believe Stravinsky was being done in Charles County. So I was pretty proud of that. We did the Symphony of Psalms along with the Serenade to Music by Vaughan Williams on that concert, as I recall. So over all the years, I'm mostly proud of the growth aspect of the group. And it did grow in numbers as well, but that's a roller coaster that goes up and down with all community organizations.
American composer Moses Hogan is best known for his settings of American spirituals. During his short lifetime, he has published over 80 arrangements for choral voices. Every Time I Feel the Spirit was arranged for soprano, alto, tenor, baritone, and bass soloists with choir. With our soloists, Denise Pratt, Kathy Compton, Mike Mickey, and Alonzo Johnson, please enjoy this uplifting selection, Every Time I Feel the Spirit.
Every time I feel the spirit moving in my heart, yes, I will pray.
Andre J. Thomas is another American composer. He has conducted and performed nationally and internationally and is the author of various choral education editions. He is a champion of performing American spirituals in an updated classical style. This work creates a poignant musical image of heaven. With Michael Santana as accompanist and Leroy Presley conducting, we present Dr. Andre J. Thomas's setting of Beautiful City.
A charter member of the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society, there are so many memories that I could share, but the one that comes to mind was a spring concert under the direction of Lynn Schramm. It was a rainy, stormy night, and I can't remember the song we were singing, but the music was very dark. And as the music reached a crescendo, there was a loud clap of thunder from outside. And in fact, it felt like the building shook. Lynn looked over her shoulder at the audience as if to say, That was planned special effects, not divine providence. Thank you, Chesapeake Choral Arts Society members, past and present, and all the great directors and musicians who were a part of this amazing group that has evolved to a higher level over the years. I feel that I have grown and have an appreciation of all types of music. Paul Anka's song, The Times of Your Life, says it all for me.
Our final selection, Take Care of This House, was from Leonard Bernstein's very short-lived Broadway musical, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Even though the music was written by Bernstein and the book and lyrics by Alan J. Lerner, the play within a play did not even last a week. The musical examined the establishment and the issues of the White House during the 19th century. It talked about the presidents and first ladies and about slavery and the American Civil War. This selection was originally a solo that was later arranged for choir. Even though the performance was done a few years ago, the text is still appropriate for today. Even though Take Care of This House referred to the White House, it could also mean take care of your house, your neighborhood, or even you. We will leave the interpretation up to you. On behalf of the Chesapeake Choral Arts Society's members and conductors, past and present, we wish you continued hope, health, happiness, and love.
Let us break in, sound the alarm.
As Chesapeake Choral Arts Society acknowledges our 25th anniversary year, we would like to thank the many choir members who volunteered their time and musicianship to form this choral group. They came together as individuals with a desire to sing and become a well-disciplined musical performing group.